My name is Tonya Wilholt, and I go to school at Grand Valley State University.
Well, hello, I'm Roger Munyon, and for about the past 20 years, I've been working at a number of radio stations in West Michigan.
Hello, my name is Robert Strutz, and I am a printing die mounter.
My name is Cheri Rawson. I'm a housewife. I homeschool my children.
My name is Barbara Penning, and I am a program aide with the Gerontology Network.
I'm in Mayne. I go to Crestwood Middle School, and I'm 13 years old.
When there's time to squeeze in, I like to hang around the Community Access Center.
I have directed football games and basketball games.
I edit, direct, I'm a cable caster, cameraman.
We take a port-a-pack and go into people's homes and talk about their antique collections.
I produce my own TV show, West Michigan Travel.
Camera operator and cable caster.
I've done game shows.
And I run shotgun mic and camera in the swap meets and basketball.
Access allows people to come in and do their own television. It gives them the accessibility to be able to communicate their feelings or their talents or their opinions and not have to pay a large amount of fees to do that. So public access basically gives the people accessibility to the field of communication that's not available in broadcasting.
I've had the freedom to produce as I like to see a project produced. I've had the freedom to express my views as I like to see them expressed.
It actually involves the community with themselves, and it gets people to know who their neighbors are, gets people to know what the issues are in their city. It gets people in touch with their own community, not to mention it gives them an outlet for any kind of an opinion that they have. It's exciting to see how much our community is beginning to use public access and how it's growing, and more people know that they have an outlet to say something.
We have a lot of organizations such as the Chamber of Commerce, the Wyoming JCs. They use that to really promote their organization and what services they provide to the community. And then we have individuals. We have individuals that will do a flower show, for example, how to grow violets, to all the way up to people that will actually entertain.
The people of the community can say what they want to say. They can make their views known, and they can in ways that they would never be able to with broadcast because of the standards of broadcast. Not that they're wrong, just that they're expensive.
Well, the work with public access, it has made it possible for me, myself personally, to try to educate Black history to our young people.
I cover fairs, festivals that go on in West Michigan during the summer months primarily.
I'm editing a documentary on a solar powered car right now.
If it's fresh and innovative and fun and it can be done on a budget of about $8.40, Jim says go for it.
At the time, the editing system was two old Panasonic 9000 series 3/4 inch decks. I recall at the time that there was no money to fix them, and so you could never get them to pre-roll. And I went out into the parking lot and got some tar and put it on the roller that made that work, like, because belt dressing is made out of tar. And that sort of fixed it until we could, you know, really afford parts.
We do public access, which is purely people coming in. We train people how to work the cameras, and they produce their own television shows. We've also taken one more step further because of the demand from the community. They would like to see community events on the channel. So we developed a volunteer program to help run the station and also go out and tape these community events. And we call that community television, whereas staff is co-producers with the people in the community. Community television, because we use volunteers and we use them as crew, really gives us the opportunity to use that as a training ground for public access users.
We're not shy on taking somebody that, you know, that really is interested in operating a piece of equipment and or like a camera or something, and putting them right behind a camera and telling them, you know, just basically what you need to know, and then put a headset on them and have a director, an experienced director, guide that person through the operation of what was going on. And I think a person really learns a lot more from by doing that.
Emphasis at 23 has always been on one of educating the person. As they come through, they begin to grow and learn how to do what they're doing better.
There are people here who could not be classified as professionals in the industry, but they are professionals. I mean, the quality of their work, the quality of their shooting, their camera work, their editing, that kind of stuff, it's professional, and I would put them up against any of the quote-unquote real professionals in the industry. And on top of that, I would rather work with them just because they're such a pleasure to work with.
I think we cover high school swimming about as well as anybody, commercially or otherwise, could cover swimming. We become the professionals at remote production in this community. And I say that to all of our commercial friends out there. I challenge you to come and watch us sometime and watch us set up, and you'll have a high degree of respect for the non-professional volunteers that work with us.
For the gas of the truck, and we also had a problem around the station of nobody getting rid of their pop cans. So what we've done now is we take all the pop cans, we have a big bin for our pop cans collection, and we turn that in, and that's actually putting the money in the truck for gas. Our truck pretty well runs down the highway on pop cans now.
One of the things that keeps TV23 and makes us different is the quality of the volunteers that we try to enlist. The volunteers really do make the center.
They're really our energizers. We can be dead on our butt, and you're looking at the clock and saying, oh, it's another Friday night, and you're going home. By the time the crew arrives at 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, and everybody's getting in position to tape the game, it's just like it's a whole new day. It's like you had slept 8 hours, and you're back on the job again the next day, and next thing you know, it's midnight, and it's time to go home then.
The people down there are wonderful to work with. It's like a sense of family, and it's fun.
A lot of camaraderie, you know. A lot of good friendships can develop.
I enjoy working with these people. They're a lot of fun, and we all enjoy doing the same kind of things, even though it's work.
It's fun to get to make TV instead of just sit around watching it.
I enjoyed doing a little bit of challenging work.
It is an awful lot of fun. It's a learning experience. And let's face it, until I can scrape up enough money to go to Hollywood, this is where it's going to happen.
You get to do everything.
I think that's what community television is all about.